conference matchup between the Cape and Mount Carmel Crusaders and the Heights Falcons. Sorry about the delay. We had some technical difficulties, but they are all handled, and we're here now. And a strong start for the Crusaders coming out, but now just a quick timeout before you have joined us at this point in the game. So for a recap, we have the starting five for the Crusaders was Lizzie Romer, Maddie Spears, Mason Palace, McCoy Pfister, and Ella Rudy. And the Crusader team holding a strong 12-7 record so far in this season. And then for the Heights Falcons squad, a solid 17-2 so far, with their key players being Kennedy Jackson, Maya Mayberry, Zeri Walker, Samaya Ellis, and Jalia Manuel. And Knipp with the rebound for the Crusaders. And Spears holding it as it is poked away from Knipp by Maya Mayberry. We'll get it to Ellis. And Ellis will draw the foul from the Crusaders. It'll be on number 33, Clara Hawker, her first. That'll be team fourth. And Ellis to shoot two here. And no good on the first. We had some substitutions from both sides here. And that will bring this game to a tie. Looks to be a violation, maybe crossed the line here. It's Heights basketball. Sanders with the defense on Ellis. And Manuel draws the foul. It'll be on Romer, her first. And both the pass foul is coming down in the post. She is good on the first, giving Heights Falcons their first lead of this game tonight. And Spears will come away with the rebound off the brick free throw. Pfister, a key offensive player for the Crusader squad, and her pass, heavily covered by Ellis, goes off the hands of Sadie Sanders. And Kennedy Jackson with the missed three brought down by Pfister. And Romer for three, no good. That is her key scoring spot on the court, but no good on that one. So Ellis, no good on the driving layup. And the ball, she did not get the ball off, so that layup by Zeri Walker will not count. So end of the first quarter, Crusaders 6, Falcons 7. Not much offense so far in this one tonight. Both teams playing strong defensively, keeping it close. The Crusaders need to try to find more opportunities beyond the arc, as Heights defense is pressuring them into a lot of forced passes, so clean little things up and it should improve for them. And Heights playing with a lot of energy, hard defense, physical game, and they should continue their success tonight, looking to improve to an 18-2 record, and the Crusaders looking to improve to 13-7, both having impressive seasons in the Greater Wichita Athletic League. And tonight, hosting, I'm Grayson Greer, and Andrew Guyer not able to join us tonight as he is on a trip. So just me for this one. And it is also senior night here at KMC. So looking forward to those festivities tonight. It'll be Falcons basketball. And it will be Ellis into Mayberry to start this second quarter. And Palace cleanly takes away the missed pass by Jackson. That'll be a foul. Sanders absorbs some contact coming off the screen. That will be on Samaya Ellis, her second team first. The ball is tipped, but still ends up in the hands of Pfister. The Crusaders have had a hard time creating space tonight. That jumper is barely missed. It'll be a jump ball, and it will stay KMC basketball. And it'll be Ellie Knipp to check in for Sadie Sanders. Crusaders hard to find space as these Falcons are tightly guarding, but doing a great job of moving around from this hounding defense from the Falcons. And good on the putback is Mason Palace off the missed floater, with Pfister taking a lot of contact. Jackson out to Ellis with Ellis at the top of the key. Slow moving possession here for the Falcons. No. Ellis driving, but he'll lose the ball and end up. And Manuel, no good there with multiple Crusaders on defense. Ball will be taken away by Mayberry. She drives. It'll be Crusader basketball, as it looks like the ball hit the out-of-bounds line. Definitely a physical game tonight so far between these two teams, as lots of contact on both sides in the paint. And it's Pfister to Knipp. He's trying to escape a trap. And a Romer who loses it. So it'll be poked away by Mayberry. Jackson. And Brown with the air ball three, ending up in the hands of Pfister. And Pfister will be called for an offensive foul. Looks like she was hooking around number three, Kennedy Jackson, on the defense. So it'll be Mayberry to bring the ball down the court for the Falcons. And Brown finding her way between the defenders with a good layup. And that will be her fourth point of the night coming off the bench. Crusaders not been getting much on offense here. Long possessions, but not ending up with points on the board. Looking to change that as it'll be knocked out of the hands of Knipp. But she'll get it back after Manuel throws it to her. I mean, I don't know how some of these are not called fouls. And here we have Mayberry slowing it down at the top of the key. But it'll be a Heights timeout as they go into this timeout. It's a 9-8 lead. and low shooting percentages from both teams tonight. 14% from field goal for the Falcons and 30 from the Crusaders. So lots of points for layups, lots of paint play tonight, and a physical one, as you have seen. And as the teams head back onto the court here, it'll be Heights basketball. And Jackson to check into Mayberry. Start the clock again, 4.5 left in the second quarter. And Knipp with the defense on Mayberry. Brown into Walker. And Rudy completely takes the ball out of the hands of Brown as she drove in for the layup. And Spears will bring it down. Ball to Romer. Romer, no good. And Spears to bring it down for the Crusaders after another defensive stop. Knipp driving. No good on the layup as she beat the defense of Walker. And Jackson gets it to Brown at the top of the key. She'll end up with it at the block. And short jumper for Zari Walker is good. Be Romer into Knipp. That will be bring Heights lead. First points on the board in a while from either team. Hawker with it at the top of the key. Gets it to Knipp. She will hold it to Romer at the three-point line. Struggling to get ball out. Will be jump ball possession, Wichita Heights. Hawker and they're fighting for it. As Hawker and Spears will be checked out for Rudy and Palace. And foul be on Romer, it appears, on Ellis as she was heading up. Sorry, it was on Palace, her first. And Ellis to shoot two. And that will bring the Heights lead up to 4, largest lead of the night by either team. And Pfister bring it down for the Crusaders. 5-point deficit here to overcome, so not too bad. Gets it to Knipp. And the Crusaders still struggling to beat this hard defense from the Falcons. Fisher takes it down the baseline as the floater is good, high off the glass. Impressive move by her. Mayberry gets it to Ellis. She loses it. It's up with Ellis And Mayberry, good for three. That is her first points of the night. Nip back out to Palace. Be a charge called on Lizzie Romer. Her second personal, and it'll be Spears to check in for Romer. It looks like to be Mayberry will bring it up for the Falcons. And 45 seconds left here in the first half. Ellis. It'll be a double dribble called. So it'll be Crusader basketball with 31 left in the half. Pfister to bring it down for the Crusaders. Trying to get something here heading into the half. Knip to Spears. Spears to Pfister. And Pfister into Rudy. Rudy fighting it, loses it. Ends up in the hands of Mayberry. She shoots one, no good. So it will be halftime here. Heights Falcons 16, Crusaders 10. And thank you for joining us for this first half. I will join you in the second. Welcome back to the second half of the matchup between the Heights Falcons and your Capen Mount Carmel Crusaders. This starts Capen possession. The Spears to Pfister. Pfister no good on the driving layup. Be a foul called on it appears to be number 42, Ella Rudy, as she fought for the rebound. And Clara Hawker will check in for her. And a low scoring game in the first half. And so we'll see how both the teams attempt to turn this around. Heights playing very tough face guard defense against the Crusaders, and they've struggled to overcome it. So we'll see how they face that. Pfister bring down the court quick. She gets around Mayberry. Romer into Hawker. And Palace to Spears. And Romer. And Palace holding it, gets it to Spears. And Spears good with the little fadeaway jumper. And her first points of the night. And Mayberry will bring it down the court for the Falcons. Via Ellis holding it, Spears on defense. Ellis no good on the three. Romer end up with it. And Pfister to bring it down for the Crusaders. Spears into Hawker. Hawker out to Palace. Pfister for three. Good. And that will bring the game down to a one-point difference. And that offensive spark appearing to go for the Crusaders at the beginning of the second half. As it Palace and Hawker poke it away. And no good on the layup for Walker. With Hawker on the defense, but Pfister bring it down the court. Spears to Pfister. And Romer draws the foul, driving into the lane. She takes lots of contact there. It will be on Manuel, her first team first. And good on the first is Romer. And Romer to take the lead here with this one. And that is the Crusaders' first lead of this one since the first quarter. Jumping right back into it with great energy coming out of halftime. It'll be Jackson for three. No good. Will end up in the hands of Pfister. And she'll bring it down the court for the Crusaders. Gets it to Spears. Palace traveling as she passed. Taking an extra step there. She'll head towards the direction of the Heights Falcons. It'll be Samaya Ellis to bring it down the court for them. Gets it to Mayberry. Jackson for three. Good. That is Jackson's first points of the night. Romer driving off the bottom of the backboard, taking a lot of contact on that drive. It's Ellis no good as she drove against three Capen defenders. Pfister bring it down. Out to Romer. Spears to Hawker. And Pfister will hold it at the wing. And Romer driving will draw the foul. She will shoot two. And that will be on Zari Walker. At her first, team second. And Romer to shoot two. And good on the first. As Ellie Knipp will check in for Maddie Spears for the Crusaders. And good. So that will tie this one up at 19. Kennedy Jackson bringing the ball down the court for the Falcons as they have slowed up on offense here so far in this third quarter. And Ellis no good on the jump shot. Palace fighting for the rebound, but she will step out of bounds. So we'll stay with the Falcons. Inbound gets to the hands of Jackson. She will get it to Walker at the corner. Hawker on defense. And no good on the three from Mayberry as a foul as Palace knocked to the ground. That'll be Walker's second. Both coming in this third quarter. And Maddie Spears checking in for Romer. Pfister gets it past half court. Driving baseline. No good on the layup. And Ellis making a drive of her own. Gilbert struggling to find. And that will be Maya Mayberry. Good after getting the pass from Gilbert. Pfister trying to get it to Hawker. And we'll say Crusaders basketball, saying that the ball was brushed by the Falcon defense. As Lizzie Romer will check in for Clara Hawker. And Pfister will receive the inbound. Spears to Palace. Palace will draw the fouls. At the hand of Gilbert was caught. And that'll be her first, team fourth. Inbound to Palace in the corner to Pfister. Romer, good with the fadeaway bucket. That is Romer's ninth point of the night. Mayberry trying to drive past Knipp. And Ellis will draw the foul, so she will shoot two. And Ellis to shoot the first. And that one falls. As both teams having decent nights from the free throw line, as she sinks the second, and 70% from the free throw line for the Heights Falcons tonight. Hawker driving. She will get fouled. We called on Walker as she was both hit the ground hard. And Walker, that is her third. And Hawker to shoot two. The first of the pair falls. That will be her first point of the night. No good on the second. Capen also shooting well from the free throw line tonight, 75%. And good on the jump shot is Jackson, her fifth point of the night. Spears to Hawker, Pfister. Palace's pass to Knipp intercepted to Ellis. Driving will get fouled by Palace. That's Palace's second. And Samaya Ellis shoot the first of the pair. And Sadie Sanders checks in for Pfister. As a physically demanding game so far tonight, very physical. And no good on the second. Ellis, Palace with the rebound, loses it. Gets it into the hands of Sanders. She'll push it down the court with Hawker getting it. And Hawker back up to Spears. Knipp on the wing, driving. Hits the ground hard, and we'd call the jump ball. Heights will take possession after the jump ball. It will be Mayberry to bring it down for the Falcons. Harris and to Manuel. Manuel no good. Gilbert will get it. She'll get the foul. It'll be a appears to be on Spears. But some discussion. Looks like the shots will be shot right now. So teams will have to come back onto the court as a second is put back onto the clock. It'll be an inbound, sorry. As play will resume once the cheerleaders leave the court. And Manuel misses the easy lay-in at the buzzer. So we'll head into the fourth quarter. Capen 22, Heights 26. Both teams finding better offensive opportunities in the second half. And the Crusaders finding more shooting opportunities as they have not had much activity from behind the three-point line as they usually would. Only attempting three so far of the night. Two of those have been good. But a tough physical battle tonight from both sides of the ball. The Crusaders and Falcons will come out of the timeout well rested than they have been, as not many stoppages of play in that third quarter, as no timeouts were taken by either team. And here we will begin the fourth quarter of tonight's matchup, the last GWAL matchup for both of these teams. Heights Falcons having a strong record of 17-2 so far this season. The Crusaders 12-7. Romer for three. No good. Rudy picking up the rebound off the tip, but she will travel. So that will be Falcon basketball. Mayberry bringing it down for the Falcons. She'll get it back. Ends up in the hands of Ellis. Ellis driving against Spears. Gets it out to Kennedy Jackson. And the pass from Walker to Ellis. No good, as it sails over the head of Ellis. The Crusader basketball. And Fister bring it down. She will give it to Spears. Crusaders playing quick here. The Caden basketball as Jackson poked it away from the hands of Romer. So Fister to inbound here. And to Romer. Back out to Fister at the wing. Romer in double team down to Palace. Is not getting the foul call she wanted, missing the layup. Mayberry holding it. It's to Ellis on the other side. Ellis to Jackson. Into Manuel. And it will be a foul on Ella Rudy. Her fourth. And it looks like Hawker will check in for Rudy. And Manuel, no good on the first. It's the Crusaders trailing by four in this one. Manuel, good on the second, bringing the Falcon lead to five. Fister to bring it down for the Crusaders. Driving, the layup will be no good. Mayberry to Ellis. And the Jackson holding it. And no good from three. And Ellis' shot wound up in the hands of Palace, then to Fister. Fister to Romer. And missed shot is up in the hands of Romer. Romer getting the reach-in foul on number three, Kennedy Jackson. Be her second, team first of the quarter. Rebound into Hawker. Hawker back into Romer. Be a foul. Looks like. Oh. will be on Jackson, her third. And Pfister for three off the inbound, no good. He'll end up out of bounds. The Falcons basketball here. And Ellie Knipp checking in for McCoy Pfister. And Ellis will bring it down for the Falcons. And Hawker with the rebound. Gets it to Spears. As she gets it taken away by Ellis. Ellis driving for the layup. No good. It'll be off the head of Ellis. It'll be Crusader basketball. As they have not been able to put points on the board in a sum of time. Looking to change that here. Knipp gets around the screen from Palace to Spears. Spears steps up. No good from three. And looks to be foul call. And it'll be on Mayberry, her first personal, team third. Rummert inbound, not finding anything. Throws it up for Hawker. Hawker to Knipp. Knipp driving. Goes up with it, no good. Taking a lot of contact on the way. And it will be a timeout for the Falcons as they cross half court. And a physical game so far. And something to note with number 12, Lizzie Romer on the court, recently scoring her 1,000th career point in her high school career for the Crusaders. So an impressive feat from her and a great milestone to hit. Eighth Capen Crusader ever to hit 1,000 point mark. And she will look to continue her success in collegiate athletics next year, as she is the one senior for this Crusaders team. So quite young talent here as they hold close in this game versus the Falcons. Definitely looking to improve offense, and Heights hoping to continue what they're doing. Fighting on defense. And notable for the Crusaders, Rudy starting tonight, but now sitting on the bench as she has four personal fouls. So maybe an appearance of her later in the game. And it will be the Falcons to inbound. Mayberry. Pass it in to Ellis. Spears waiting as Ellis gets it to Walker. And then back to Ellis. Mayberry on the drive. No good on the layup. As Palace's pass will go between the legs of Hawker. It'll be Falcon basketball as Rudy checks in for Palace. It'll be Mayberry to check in for the Falcons. She gets it into Ellis. She dribble it. Ellis to Jackson. Jackson to Walker. Mayberry no good for the deep three. Rudy with the rebound, giving it to Spears. Spears trying to get down the court with the defense from Ellis. We called a timeout for the Crusaders. And that will be their first timeout here. And definitely talking over, maybe getting their girls at rest, definitely letting Falcons rest as well. I think that timeout was called in the quick moment Ospina struggling to get down the court as the Crusaders still fighting a 5-point deficit here to the Falcons. And they look to hopefully turn that around here. It'll be Romer to inbound for the Crusaders. She'll get it into Pfister on defense, Jackson. Pfister to Knipp. Knipp loses the ball off of her foot. Pfister driving. Foul will be called. It'll be on number 34. That'll be Jelaya Manuel. That is her second personal, and Pfister to shoot two. The first will be good. As Crusaders throwing up some more three-point shots so far in the second half, since they have now attempted seven. And Pfister makes the second free throw, so good on both. The Mayberry. And pass will end up in the hands of Rudy. Rudy getting to Pfister. Pfister gets it to Knipp. Knipp driving. Get it back out to Spears. Romer for three. No good. And it'll be called Falcons basketball. And almost a huge moment for the Crusaders there. But barely miss on the three-point bucket. Mayberry to bring it down for the Falcons with 3 minutes left in this matchup. Jackson, good. On the right-hand floater in the paint after the drive. Pfister. Driving. No good. Gets it in to Rudy. Rudy back out to Pfister. Pfister to Rudy. Rudy to Spears. Spears no good on the floater. Romer fights for the rebound. No foul called there. There's lots of contact. And Falcons will slow it down with Ellis. She drives out to Walker, out of the hands of Zari Walker. And Palace checks in for Knipp. And a great matchup here so far. Palace holding it to Spears. Spears into Rudy. Rudy backing it down. No good. And it'll be a foul on Palace as she attempts the rebound. And a good hustle attempt there from her. But she threw Falcon player to the deck. So it'll be Mayberry to check in. The Crusaders having a full court press here. Romer to play defense on Kennedy Jackson. Jackson driving. In the hands of Ellis. And it'll be Crusader timeout as they hold. And the Falcons still holding that 5-point lead here. And crunch time for the Crusaders. It's a minute 17 left here in this game. And it is do or die time for them, as quick points have not been a theme in this one, as you can tell from the low score total. 24, Crusaders 29, Falcons talking over, trying to get maybe some more shot opportunities, as those have been hard to come by with this Falcons defense tonight. The Falcons capitalizing off of some miscues on the defense, on switching, making prominence out of their drives and for floaters. It will be Ellis to check in for the Falcons. Gets it to Mayberry. Fisher on the defense. Gets it to Jackson. Crusaders trying to trap, but a foul called. It'll be on Fister, her second, team third. It'll be Jackson inbounding. Gets it to Mayberry. She'll bring it down the court. Fister pokes it loose, ends up in the hands of Ellis. Be a timeout by the Heights Falcons. So they were struggling to make it down the court. And the Crusaders definitely needing to find some points here. As I mentioned earlier, it is do or die to get these points on the board as they trail by five. Falcons need to hold on to the ball and try to run this clock out and not give the Crusaders any opportunities to get a hold of the ball. As we come out of this timeout, it will be Mayberry to inbound for the Falcons. She gets it into Ellis. Fury on defense, her first time checking into this game, as it looks like a push off maybe, as it'll end up in the hands of Jackson. Falcons just trying to do anything. It'll be a foul from Spears, her second. It'll be team fourth, as it'll be Mayberry to inbound again for the Falcons. Gets it in to Jackson. Be a foul by Spears. Her third. It'll be Jackson to shoot two. And she's good on the first. And Ella Rudy to check in for number 41, Stella Fury, as she had a quick time on the court. And good on the second is Jackson and Fister to try to push the ball down. As she gets past the defense of Jackson, out to Spears. Spears to Romer, almost loses it. And we'll drive, put up a shot, short, no good. Be Ellis, the ball for the Falcons. Gets it to Jackson. Be a foul by Romer. And the Falcons will shoot two. As it will be Kennedy Jackson for another pair of free throws. And with 13 seconds left, Pierce, there's not much that the Crusaders can do at this point to save this one. Jackson is good on the first. And the Falcons shooting well from free throw tonight. 12 for 17. And the second will be good as well, bringing the Heights lead to 9. Fister pushing it down the court. She will lose ball, and it'll end up back in the hands of the Falcons. It looks like they will come away with this win. Crusaders will walk away with a loss, still finishing strong so far before we head into playoffs, 12-3. But the Wichita Heights Falcons improving to 18-2 on the season. We will send you over as the senior night festivities will begin, and we will join you again for the matchup between Heights and Crusaders for the men's game. I'm Grayson Greer, and I will join you in the next one.
Our 40 seniors, first up is Brooks Powers.
And I received a special request from Senior Brooks Powers. Shout out to his grandparents who were not able to make it tonight, and Bo and Jackson, as he wants to thank you guys for how much you guys have supported him throughout the years. And he wants to say how much he loves you, and he appreciates all of the years you've been with him. Hello and welcome to tonight's matchup with the Capen Mount Carmel Crusaders taking on the Heights Falcons. And both teams coming into this one at the top of their game. The Crusaders coming in very solid, 17-2 record, with their latest loss coming on Tuesday versus the Northwest Grizzlies, losing that one 49-51. The Heights Falcons coming in all class rank number one, playing excellent basketball, 18-1 with their most recent win against the West Pioneers on Tuesday. As the crowd gets amped up for this one, as we get ready for tip off for this incredible matchup. If the Crusaders win this one, they will tie for City League, and it will be co-champions with the Falcons. The Falcons looking to win and secure it for themselves as they also win this tip-off. And that will be TJ Williams. The first point for Falcons. Tegan Charles giving it to Corbin Johnson. Thankful up top for three. Short, no good. TJ Williams will bring it down to Robinson. Herlocker on defense. Get back to Williams up top. Powers and Charles on the defense. Robinson misses the layup. Johnson to Thangvall. Thangvall to Charles. Charles will get fouled. The two shots. And Charles looking to put the first points on the board for the Crusaders. That'll be Williams first, team first. And Charles to shoot. No good on the first. Charles no good on the pair of free throws. So that has been a struggling point for the Crusaders so far this year. Robinson trying to get around Herlocker. Robinson back with the ball driving. Be blocked by Herlocker, but it will stay Falcon basketball. And head coach Joe Auer doing an incredible job with this Heights team over the past few years. And they look to be continuing their success this year with this last matchup of the G-Wall regular season. It'll be Mbule for three. No good. And it'll be Herlocker off the tip. Corbin Johnson for three. Good! As the Crusaders take a one-point lead with their first points of the game. Robinson guarded by Herlocker. We'll give it to Timmons. Timmons driving against Thangvall, gets it. And that'll be good for Mbul. Brooks Powers to bring it down for the Crusaders. The Thangvall driving back out to Powers. Powers to the other side. Pass intercepted by Robinson. And Wilkins good on the fast break layup for the Falcons. Crusaders slowing it down here. Thankful, back to Johnson. Trying to get around the screen from Charles. Charles backing down, no good. As Robinson was on the defense there. And the pass from Mbul to Wilkins. Out of the hand to Wilkins, the Crusader basketball. And Johnson will inbound for the Crusaders to Powers. Crusaders need to get some points here. as this Heist team is very explosive. Her locker back to Powers. Thangvall holding it at the top of the key, guarded by Robinson. Driving, no, blocked, gets it to Charles. Charles, no good. It'll be a foul on Charles, his first. Wilkins get back down the court after taking a shot to the mouth. The TJ Williams to bring it down for the Falcons. And Williams, the hook shot good over Powers. That'll be his fourth point of the game. Powers gets the foul as he takes some contact from Malachi Wilkins. His first. And he will be checked out for number 44, Isaiah Carter. And Keller in for Charles for the Crusaders. Keller, not usually a player to come off the bench, but tonight he is. And Johnson with the fadeaway shot. Good. This will be his fifth point, scoring all of them for the Crusaders so far. Johnson with the defense on Mboul. Williams drives out to the corner. And Timmons, good 4-3 for the Falcons. Powers drives, blocked by Williams. And Mboul bring it down the court, gets it back to Williams. He gets it to Timmons up top. Robinson to Mboul. Robinson holding it. Mboul into Williams. Williams to Robinson. Timmons missed, no good on the three from the corner. Powers, Johnson. Johnson over, no good. Keller comes away with it. Powers for three, no good. Chase Robinson comes away with the rebound. Give it to Williams to bring it down the court. Williams, the 6'6 guard for the Falcons, a big senior player for this Heights team. Herlocker fence on Robinson. He gets it out to Timmons. Timmons drives and good over Rocco Keller. And that will be KMC's first timeout, as Coach Steve Eck will want to talk things over with his team. And a slow start for the Crusaders as a huge three from Johnson in the fadeaway bucket, but nothing else going for them. And the Crusaders will have the ball coming out of this timeout. Innings players rested, talking it over, maybe looking for an answer to stopping this Heights explosive offense. With the big sequence of events coming from the three from Timmons in the corner, and then a huge block by Williams on the other end. But now a fresh restart for this Crusaders team, as Blaze Dalian has checked into the game for Owen Herlocker. And it will be Johnson to inbound. Looks like they were wiping off the court. And Johnson inbound to Powers, and he'll bring it down. And Dalian, number 15 for the Crusaders, a freshman, but plays a huge six-man role on this Crusaders team. And Johnson to Thangvall in the corner. Thangvall, no good. And Williams to bring it down the court for the Falcons. Will be number four with defense on number four. Williams surveying the court, driving by Thangvall. Three toilet bowls out, but the Crusaders not able to grab the rebound. And a very close make for Kamari Holt. And Robinson will check in for the Falcons along with his teammate Avin Mbul. TJ Williams, no good. And that will be blocked by Charles, but it will stay with the Falcons as Isaiah Carter went for the putback. But Charles said bye-bye to that ball. Thangvall, defense on Robinson. Robinson to Williams. And the freshman, Dalian, with defense on the senior. Williams with the ball at the top of the key. Thangvall with the defense. And there'll be a foul will be called as the Crusaders attempt to intercept that pass. It'll be on number 15, Blaze Dalian. And Coach Steve Eck not agreeing with that one. We have Jalen Timmons checking in for TJ Williams. The inbound gets to Wilkins. Robinson backing down Dalian, and he will step out of bounds on the baseline. It'll be Crusaders basketball. Dalian will inbound with Johnson, bring it down the court as Powers is out of this game for Charles. Thangvall gets it to Dalian, defended by Timmons, into Charles. Keller to Johnson. Johnson trying to find teammates. Keller loses it. Okay, tip. I don't know, not sure what the call is here. It'll be a foul called on number 44, Isaiah Carter of the Heights Falcons. His first. Team third. 10 seconds remain in this first quarter. Crusaders needing a quick bucket here. Johnson with a fadeaway corner three. Now Robinson to put up, and it goes over the backboard. Not sure if Johnson fully knew what time was left on the clock there. But the Crusaders trailing by eight here to this very talented Falcons team. The Crusaders with a lot of talent on their side in this senior night matchup. The Falcons will be tough to come back from an 8-point deficit as they play so hard on defense. Falcons doing a great job of finding open guys, confusing the defense, getting open opportunities for threes or jump shots. Both teams shooting 20% from three tonight. 1-for-5 for both teams. The Crusaders having opportunity at free throws with Cheegan Charles, but he missed both of those. Coming out of the quarter here, Crusaders need to find a spark of life on offense. And coming back out onto the court will be Brooks Powers for the Crusaders as Keller is subbed out. And wiping the court here, And then we will get the inbound. And play will resume as Johnson will take it down to Thangvall. Powers in the corner. Dalian back to Thangvall. Dalian for three. No good. Powers with the rebound back in to Thangvall. Thangvall goes up and over. Right hand good. And his first points of the night. A block foul. So and one for Robinson. And so Johnson will pick up his first in this one. And Robinson to attempt the first free throw for the Falcons tonight. No good. Thangvall coming away with the rebound. He pushes it down. And a charge will be called on Thangvall. And Coach Steve Eck, very unpleased with that one. As Johnson was in the same position on the other side of the court just a few moments ago. Lee Williams to bring it down for the Falcons. Gets it to Mbul. Johnson with the defense. Back to Robinson. Robinson trying for the alley-oop to Williams, but over his head. Lee Thangvall to check it in for the Crusaders. Powers to bring it down. Crusaders needing a momentum booster here. Get the crowd on their side as there's a great showing from both schools tonight. Thangvall in the corner. Three, no good. And a foul will be called as Charles fought for the rebound. Be on number 21, Amalekai Wilkins. His second personal. And Powers to inbound for the Crusaders. Gets it. Dalian to Johnson. And to Charles. Charles fights for it. No foul call given. As Robinson will bring it down the court for the Falcons. Dalian defending Robinson, and Robinson unable to come through with the layup. Johnson for a deep three. No good. As we go back the other way, Timmons. Layup high off the glass. And Coach Joe Auer losing his mind on the ref, trying to get an and one call there. Not receiving it. And Williams. Big statement dunk. As Coach Eck comes onto the floor, not happy with his team, as the Crusaders fall to a 12-point deficit, and not a good showing from them, and an excellent showing from the Falcons so far tonight. A great show of the athleticism of TJ Williams with that one. No doubt about it, once he came down the court, the Crusaders needing a heavy turnaround here as they trail 12 to the Wichita Heights Falcons. And these Heights Falcons, as they are number one in 6A ranking, they will head into the playoffs more than likely with whether it's a win or a loss tonight. We'll probably end up with the one seed in that bracket. Crusaders also looking solid, predicted with a 2 or a 3 seed going into the 5A playoff bracket. These two teams will not meet each other in the postseason. And Powers to bring it down the court for the Crusaders once again. Hand off to Johnson. Thangvall defended by Timmons. Trying to get around him. Drives. No good on the layup. And Boole driving quick. Over Johnson, off the glass, is good. As they have tripled the Crusader point total now. Powers gets it to her locker. Corner to Thengvall. Powers for three, no good. And the Crusaders have been ice cold from the three-point line tonight, as they're now just 20%, 2-for-10. And Johnson will come away with the rebound after the missed layup, pushing it down the court. Crusaders outnumbering. Missed layup by Herlocker, but a good putback by Thengvall. That'll be his fourth point of the night. Thengvall defending T.J. Williams. Williams to Timmons. Timmons into Robinson. Robinson backing down Herlocker. And good. As he outsized the junior there. Thengvall gets it to Powers. And a travel called with Powers trying to drive. And Williams to inbound for Robinson here. And Williams bring it down. Thengvall instantly coming at him. Herlocker on Robinson. Robinson drives, no good. Thengvall will come away with it. See, weaves between defenders. And he gets it poked away from behind from the Wolf. And Williams with the two-hand slam. It'll be a full timeout called by Heights, as head coach Joe Auer getting his guys rest after that massive two-hand slam by Williams, a great show of his athleticism once again. The Crusaders really struggling to find any points of success in this one and really need to turn it around. Steve Eck, a veteran coach in JUCO and Wichita High School basketball. I'm sure he is going to attempt to find a solution for this Crusader team tonight. And Herlocker to Powers. And Crusaders needing to find a way to get out of this face guard defense from the Falcons. As that pass poked away, Thengvall will end up rolling out of bounds with it at the Heights bench. It'll be Heights basketball. Robinson to Williams. Thengvall on the defense. As the Crusaders trail by 16. No good. It's Robinson on the layup, and Charles will take it down the court. And Thengvall, three from the corner. No good. And Johnson with the defense on Holt. Timmons. Powers with the defense. Holt loses it for a second, but recovers. Williams guarded by Charles to Robinson. Robinson driving. And a foul called on the ground with the drive attempt. It'll be on Will Thengvall. And lots of confusion. He wasn't even close to the ball. And I think they might have the wrong person here. As Herlocker will sit down or check in for Thengvall. But now lots of confusion. And now both coaches upset as Heights coach wants this game to resume. And X still not happy as Thengvall picked up his second there. The ref getting an earful. Robinson gets it in off of the back of Timmons, but in the hands of Williams. And Timmons no good for three. And Johnson bringing it down for the Crusaders. Gets it to Powers. Powers drives. No good on the layup. Covered by Charles. Again recovered by Keller, and that will be called for a foul. It'll be number 10. Jalen Timmons called on the foul. His first, team second. And 2 minutes remain in this half. As the Crusaders now 0 for 3 from free throw. That's not something you want to see. But overall struggle from Cape and Mount Carmel tonight as they have been outplayed on every level so far by the Falcons. 2 minutes till half, and definitely needing a strong coaching point and speech in this half if they want to turn things around, as they are a high-scoring offense being held to 10 points currently. And Chase Robinson to Timmons. Timmons pass tipped up by Keller. Keller will bring it down. Gets it to Johnson. Johnson on the wing gets it into Charles. Charles out to Keller. Keller looking for the drive, but the lane not there. And Johnson back into Charles. Charles good with the spin move fadeaway. That'll be his first points of the night. The Crusaders come within 13. Williams guarded by Powers. Drives. Gets it back to Robinson. And it'll be a charge called on number 12, Mbul, as he ran through Crusader defender. That'll be his first. And it looked like he's coming off the screen and ran right through him like a running back. Johnson to Powers. Powers into Thangvall. Thangvall guarded. No good on the layup. Charles good with the second chance. That'll be his fourth point from the putback. Williams to bring it down. The Crusaders try to claw back into this one. Williams spin move, but no good on the drive attempt. Gets it down, long pass to Thangvall as he will dance around the defender for a layup. And a good swing of momentum here for the Crusaders, looking to continue their success. Timmons holding it at the top, defended by Charles. As the time ticks down, as 10 seconds remain in the half. And Timmons shoots. Deep three, good. Right before the buzzer, as the Heights Falcons will take a 12-point lead. Wichita Heights 28. Cape and Mount Carmel Crusaders 16. Thank you for joining us in this first half, and I will join you in the second. the Capon chaplain, Father Curtis, making a reappearance tonight in the student section. Always appreciates his appearance. And they are happy to see you this one, and maybe he can breathe some life into this Crusader team heading into the second half. But shout out to Father Curtis and all the amazing things he has done for Capon and his time here. And welcome back to this second half of the matchup between the Wichita Heights Falcons and the Capon Mount Carmel Crusaders. Both teams coming into this game with great records, but the Falcons taking a hold of this one and have a strong grasp on it currently. The Crusaders building a bit of momentum heading into half, but then Jalen Timmons with a buzzer-beating three. And the Falcons will start with the ball here, as Chase Robinson will get it to TJ Williams. Thankful guarding Williams. Keller with the defense on Robinson, as Robinson's pass is out of bounds as a miscommunication with Mbul. And Powers long pass to Thankful. He'll dribble it around the wing, back out to Johnson. Johnson from the free throw line, good. And a nice mid-range jumper there for Corbin Johnson, his seventh of the night, bringing this deficit down to 10. Robinson gets it to Wilkins, Wilkins to Williams. Robinson backing down Keller, but getting the scoop under the basket. That is his 6 points of the night. Thankful in the corner, driving at the baseline. No good. Almost tips it back in. They'll end up in the hands of the Falcons. Williams bringing it down. As we've seen from this Falcons team, an explosive offense that can do many different things. Williams already having two dunks in this one, as Charles pass out sails Thankful. Thankful taking a slide across the court, but the TJ Williams to inbound for the Falcons. Dangvall picks up the defense at half court. Powers defending Timmons. Timmons drives. Good layup there, using his speed to find the lane. Thangvall. Johnson on the wing. Johnson to Thangvall. Thangvall for three. Good. And that will be Thangvall's first three of the game. As that usually is one of his key scoring areas. His first one tonight. And Mbuul with an instant answer for the Heights Falcons. The Crusaders looking for some points here as they trail by 14. Powers drives, but he will draw the foul as a blocking foul will be called on number 14, Kamari Holt. That'll be his first personal and team first. Powers to shoot two. And the first is good. Crusaders struggling from the free throw line tonight as they have gone 2-4-5. And Powers nails both as Timmons will give it to Williams. Williams back to Robinson. Dangvall on Williams. Kicks it out to Robinson. And Crusaders wanting a travel there. But the pass will be intercepted. Rocco Keller will hand it over to Powers. Powers keeps it. Drives. Reverse layup, no good. Gets his own rebound. Charles, no good on the putback. And no good on either opportunity there. Robinson's pass almost sails over the head of Mbuul. Robinson gets it taken away by Thangvall. He will pull up for three. No good. And Robinson will get the rebound for the Falcons. Throws it deep pass. And Johnson will foul. And he'll pick up his second personal as his arm got tangled up with Wilkins trying to receive the deep pass. It'll be Kamari Holt to check in for Avon Mbuul. And Robinson to inbound for the Falcons. Williams receiving the inbound. Wilkins holding it. Keller playing defense. Williams to Timmons. And no good on the wide open three-point attempt. Johnson to Thangvall. Johnson deep three. Good. And that is a huge three for the Crusaders, bringing it within 9 points now. Charles defending Robinson. Robinson to Timmons. Timmons driving. We get a layup over the head of multiple Crusaders defenders. Powers bringing it down for the Crusaders. Johnson pulls up for another three. No good off the mark. Powers comes away with it. Back into Thangvall. Thangvall loses it, but is poked away by the Falcons, and it will stay with the Crusaders. And number 12, Avon Mbuul to check in. And number 44, Isaiah Carter as well for the Falcons. And number 15, Blaze Dalian checked in for number 25, Brooks Powers for the Crusaders. Johnson for another three. Good. And that one, good for Johnson's 13th point of the night. The lead score here for the Crusaders so far. Coming up next, number 9, Will Thengvall. Sorry, number 4, Will Thengvall, with 9. Ghoul. Williams holds it. Defended by Thengvall. And Thengvall will be called for a foul. And Coach Steve Eck for the Crusaders will be issued a warning. And he's still talking to the ref. As that is Thengvall's third personal for what it looked to not be a foul in the eyes of the Crusaders. As Carter, Holt, check out. Timmons inbounds it, and Boole, defended by Johnson. Wilkins to Timmons. Timmons defended by the freshman, Dalian. No good on the pull-up jumper. Thengvall to push it down the court. Thengvall to Dalian. Thengvall gets it down the block, but it'll be tipped off of the hand of number 21, Wilkins. And Powers will check in for Rocco Keller. And Powers gets it into Thengvall underneath the basket. Thengvall will get blocked, but it'll be goaltending. So that will be good for Thengvall's 11th point. Keller checking in for Thengvall. And Holt checking in for Timmons. Crusaders getting back within 6. And that is a lot better than the 16-point deficit that they just had moments ago in this third quarter. Robinson in. Wilkins will draw the foul, but it'll be on the floor, so no count on the basket. That'll be on Rocco Keller, his first team, 3rd. Inbounding, Robinson gets it to Wilkins. Boole to Holt. Robinson defended by Powers. Boole trying to dribble around defensive Corbin Johnson. The class will get disrupted, but end up with TJ Williams. Robinson. Wilkins. And Boole good for 3. And there'll be a timeout by Heights. Coach Auer electing for the timeout, as it will be a full one. Both teams getting an opportunity to talk things over. The Crusaders clawing back to a 9-point deficit. And definitely not the worst they have seen tonight so far. Both teams knew coming into this one that it would be a physical and fast-paced game. Both teams with great athletes. You can feel the cheers when either team scores, as one side of the gym will erupt and the other side will stay silent. But a great showing for the Falcons and Crusaders. And the Crusaders needing this win here to be co-City League champions with the Falcons. The Falcons have their one loss to the Southeast Buffaloes. The Crusaders with their first loss being against this Falcons team at Heights earlier in the season, losing by 10 in that one. Powers for 3, off the mark a little bit deep. Robinson will come away with the rebound for the Falcons. Robinson driving, gets past Charles, and Charles will foul. that will be Charles' second personal, team fourth. And Chase Robinson to shoot two, the 6'4 guard for the Falcons. And Robinson still with another year on this Falcons team. He's a junior. And he'll make the second, so both good on the pair of free throws. And TJ Williams will check out for the Falcons as Powers brings it down the court. It's a Thangvall. Thangvall holding it at the top of the key. 20 seconds left here in this third quarter. Trying to hold it and get the last bucket. Seems to be the plan for the Crusaders. Thangvall will drive, but the clock will stop. Be on Isaiah Carter, his second, team second. And Thangvall to inbound with 9.7 left here. Gets it to Powers. Powers of Thangvall. And another foul as Timmons will grab the arm of Thangvall on the drive. That'll be his second, team third. And Thangvall to inbound once more as Timmons will get checked out for number five, Jaron Lee, the 5'9 senior guard for the Falcons. And to Powers. Powers will get fouled again as they tug his jersey. And it is an intentional foul called on number five, Jaron Lee, as he just checked into the game. Definitely something you don't want to do right as you get your first opportunity on the court. Powers to shoot two because of the intentional. And it is the team's fourth with 2 seconds left remaining in the third quarter, with the Crusaders will attempt a quick inbound. And both good for Powers, bringing the lead down to 9 for the Falcons. And a quick shot needed for the Crusaders if they want to get something before the end of this quarter. Powers to inbound. And another foul called, and it'll be on number three, Chase Robinson. As cheers throughout the KMC faithful, his first of the game, as Thangvall not getting let through during the inbound play. Good on the first of the pair. Crusaders picking up their free throw shooting, so they now are 6-for-9. Thangvall makes the second, both good. Charles steals it, fade away, no good at the buzzer. But great play by Charles, and momentum heading in to this crucial fourth quarter. A lot on the line in this one, with City League and titles as we head in to the postseason, with this the last game of the regular season for both teams. And a hard-fought battle on both sides of the ball. 7-point deficit for the Crusaders to overcome in this fourth one, as this game has been flying by so far. The Crusaders needing a spark of life as they just got before the quarter, and hopefully they can continue that momentum. The Falcons needing to not foul, as they had 4 fouls within the last 20 seconds of the quarter, and not something you want to see, especially from number five, Jaron Lee, starting that spree of fouls with the second foul, but the intentional right as he stepped onto the court. And that was a huge moment for the Crusaders to be able to get those 2 free throws and shrink the lead even more. And both teams will retake the court. as the Crusaders will inbound to start the fourth quarter. Play will resume in 8 minutes for this Crusaders team to try to manage a win here. Charles Adalian, Johnson holding it at the wing, driving and fouled, driving in. That'll be another foul for the Falcons. As we just talked, they need to stop and slow down. And that will be on Malachi Wilkins, his third personal, team's first of the quarter. And Johnson good on the first free throw. Johnson good with the second. And Robinson to bring it down. 5-point lead the Falcons hold on to. One of the smaller leads that they have had so far tonight. Williams at the top, defended by Thingball. Robinson defended by Charles. Sits to Timmons. Williams puts it to the corner to Wilkins, drives. Defended by Thankful at the block. And Wilkins will be good with the lay-in as Johnson got sent to the deck. And Powers with a very nice reverse layup there, scooping under the basket as Robinson will bring it down for the Falcons. Timmons holding it. And a foul called against number four, Will Thangvall of the Crusaders. His fourth personal. And he will check out for junior guard Owen Herlocker. As Herlocker started this one, and has seen good minutes tonight. Johnson with the defense on Mbul. Wilkins gets it into Robinson. Herlocker getting back down. And Timmons will lose the ball. Deep pass intercepted by Wilkins. And Williams will hold it again. Not a great decision there by Charles of the Crusaders. Williams defended by Charles, driving, kicks it back out. Timmons driving over the head of Herlocker. Layup is good off the glass. And Powers bring it down for the Crusaders. Powers, Johnson, and it'll be a timeout by head coach Steve Eck. Like it will be a full timeout. So a minute here to talk things over with his team. And Joe Auer now with the chance to talk things over with his team. Almost a big momentum switch, but the pass intercepted with an athletic play by Wilkins. And the Crusaders trailing 7. Closest they've been able to get it is 5. Not bad so far for the Crusaders. And foul trouble for the Crusaders being with Thingball. As he has 4 personals, it appears he will step onto the court. And Johnson will inbound here for the Crusaders. And hopefully Thingball got not get another foul here. Powers gets it to Thankful at the wing. Thankful Johnson for a deep three. No good. Tipped back out to Thingvall. Thingvall for a second opportunity. Again, ends up in his hands. He's under the basket. Kicks it out to freshman Dalian. Johnson drives. Puts up, smacked away by TJ Williams. Scramble for the ball. Ends up in Wilkins. Malachi Wilkins with the dunk on the other end of the court. And Thankful, instant response with a three. Powers defense on Timmons. Timmons holds it at the top of the key. Sits for Robinson. Wilkins guarded by Dalian. Hands off to TJ Williams, who feeds it back into Wilkins. Back out. And it'll be a foul called on Powers, his first. And very light contact for a foul to be called there. And Timmons to inbound for the Falcons. Williams defended by Thingvall, holding it. Charles. Robinson driving, picks up, dribble, finds Timmons. Long possession here so far for the Falcons. Robinson double teamed, gets it out to Timmons. TJ Williams, Timmons wide open, feeds it in to Malachi Wilkins, and it will stay. Falcon ball is poked away by Will Thankball. And Robinson gets it in to Williams, Williams to Wilkins. He drives, blocked by Charles. But Williams will get the ball, and he'll be good for a layup. Thingvall pushes it down the court for the Crusaders. Gets it to Johnson. Johnson back to Thingvall. Thingvall heavily guarded by Mbul. And pass taken away. But it will still be heading towards Falcons basket. It's Williams holding Charles on the defense. Around three minutes remained in this fourth quarter. And a blocking foul will be called on Corbin Johnson. And he and everybody with blue and white on their shirts is not happy with that call, wanting a charge. It'll be TJ Williams to shoot two. He'll make the first. And Williams bring the lead to 10 for the Falcons. And no good. Powers will come away with the rebound. Powers driving, lane not open as he's guarded by Wilkins. Thankball holding at the top. Deep three from Thankball, short. Powers fighting for the rebound with Wilkins. Will be called a jump ball, possession arrow, the Heights Falcons. And with 2.5 minutes remaining in this one, the Crusaders needing to bring that lead back within reach. As the floor will get wiped, but it will go into a timeout by the Heights Falcons. It'll be a full timeout. Steve Eck and Coach Joe Auer for the Falcons. Joe Auer probably talking how to keep this Crusader offense at bay, as they have done a very solid job at so far in this one. Steve Eck needing to find a way to get his players better offensive opportunities. And as play will resume in about 20 seconds here. About 2.5 minutes left here in the fourth quarter. As on the court for the Cape Mount Pommel Crusaders, we've got number 15, Blaze Dalian. Number 25, Brooks Powers. Number 21, Corbin Johnson. Number 4, Will Thankful. Number 22, Tegan Charles guarding the inbound. We'll get it into TJ Williams as the Crusaders create a full court press, trying to trap there as it will benefit them. Pass taken away by Powers. Thankful electing not to shoot the three there. This Powers pass head of bounds and it will stay with the Crusaders. And it will be Powers to inbound. Crusaders need a bucket here. Into Charles. Fade away. Good. He'll float one in, his sixth point of the night. Powers with the defense on Robinson. Thankful, Powers trapping Williams. Robinson pushing down the court. Timmons will take it at the wing, defended by Powers. Williams gets past Thankful. Dalian guarding. The Falcons trying to hold on to the ball as long as possible here. Williams, and one. And that will be called on number 22, Tegan Charles for the Crusaders, his third, team fourth, and a huge play for the Falcons there by their senior guard, TJ Williams. Johnson holding the ball, trying to find drive for three, good! And an impressive shot by Corbin Johnson there, bringing this lead down to 7 from the Falcons. It's 1:16 remain. A full timeout there called. And the Cape and Crusaders have one timeout left, with the Heights Falcons having two. The Crusaders got to be careful with when they use their final timeout. And a huge play from Corbin Johnson there to build momentum back up for the Crusaders. Steve Eck and his team of Crusaders coming out of the huddle with the game plan here. And the Falcons, if they get their hands on the ball, they're going to want to chew as much clock as possible. As they will inbound here, Crusaders with the press. Robinson trying to get the ball in. Over the head of Williams. Still ends up with it. And Williams will throw it over the head of Malachi Wilkins. And a flash of hope here for the Crusaders as Tegan Charles will sub in for Rocco Keller. More offensive player getting subbed in for the Crusaders here. As the clock will resume. Powers to Johnson. Johnson guarded by Timmons. Blocks by on three. New foul will be called. And it will be on number 21 and Malachi Williams, his fourth, but he will be on the floor. So Thangvall here to inbound. Gets it into Powers. Powers driving to the corner. Daly in for three. And put back, tipped in by Charles. Crusaders bring it within five. Still pressing the Falcons as Williams will get the ball. And a foul called. I'm not sure on who. And it will be on Brooks Powers, his second. And Coach Eck for the Crusaders saying there's nobody even within the vicinity. As Williams will be good on the first, increasing that lead. His 15th point of the night, second in scoring to Jalen Timmons. He'll make the second, bringing the Falcon lead back up to 7 points. Clock will start. Johnson for three, no good. And the foul has a fight for the ball there. And it'll be two shots for the Falcons. New Williams going back to the line where they have shot. Where he personally has shot well tonight. And the game slowly but surely slipping out of the hands of the Crusaders unless they can really get something here. But even more unlikely as Williams has the opportunity to increase the lead to 9 here. And he will do just that. And 40 seconds remain. Powers pushing it down the court. And two guys end up on the ground. There'll be a foul called. Number 10, Jalen Timmons, as him and Corbin Johnson make heavy contact. Thangvall inbounds to Powers. Powers to Thangvall. Thangvall for three. Off the mark. Williams again with the rebound. Foul called. And Williams to shoot. Two again. 4 for 4 on his previous attempts. And he'll make the first as the Falcons defense will sit in the backcourt, but a timeout here called by Crusaders head coach Steve Eck. As a 10-point deficit here, could be 11 if another free throw gets made. But looking to be a grim ending in the works here for the Crusaders. And the Falcons, if they win this game, will claim the City League title this year as they were co-champions with this Crusaders team last year in the G-Wall. And Williams to attempt the second free throw. It's good, so that will bring the Falcon lead to 11 points. Crusaders push it down. Johnson's three, no good. Charles. They're not giving Crusaders the foul, and they're just going to let it dribble out. Crusaders 49, Heights Falcons. 60. Sanders will lose by 11. The Falcons will claim the G-Wall title and continue their successful run this season. And a great coaching job from Joe Auer. And both teams will look to continue in the playoffs. And we will probably be joining you for that. Have a good night, and we will see you in the next one.